type of villain am I? Which element am I drawn to the most? Water. If you could describe yourself in two words, what would they be? I'm pretty loyal, I think. Well, I might be a bit self-aware. I think I'm self-aware. I know myself. Oh, wait. Oh, I can pick two. I'll go with loyal and self-aware. How about that? Pick a color. Purple. Which trait are you most drawn to in others? Respect. Warm or cold? Cold? Loud or quiet? Quiet. Self or people? I am the people. Are you an emotional person? Maybe sometimes it depends. What is your Hogwarts house? I did a Pottermore thing. I've actually not completely watched all of Harry Potter, but I know enough just by osmosis. Instead of watching it, I just watch recap videos and theories. I did it twice. Same Patronus. The only difference is my wand grew half an inch. If you could have any superpower, what would it be? I feel like mind reading is like, do I want to know what other people are reading? Maybe, maybe not. I don't want to control others. I don't even know what I want to do, let alone what I want other people to do. I'll go with invisibility. Choose one. Puzzle? Give me balance in all things. In which future sounds the best? The most interesting? Going with the person I love most. I'm the criminal! I forgot what kind of quiz I was taking. Money, power, pride, fame! These are the things that make the criminal tick. They crave what they cannot have and will do what they can to get what they want or what they think they deserve. The criminal values what they love most and will protect anyone, those they love, to no cost. Oh! Okay, I can get behind that. Even though money is and always will be a great factor for them. To be a criminal is to survive, and the criminal is incredibly in tune with themselves, their instincts, their limits, and what they want more than anything in the world. I mean, that's basically the layperson. Let's be real here. Any regular citizen of the street, they can fit this as long as they decide to be more chaotic. What is your personality like based off your fears? Let's go! So I'm actually quite curious to see if this experiment I'm conducting is actually accurate. I thought it was gonna ask if it was completely ethical. You are amongst a large crowd of people at a somewhat fancy event that I was made to go to. What do I do? I try to stay around only a few particular people. Like, if Nat was here, I would just stick to her the entire time. It's like, please. Like, she can get by in a social situation. I need more convincing. Interesting. What appeals to you the least? Bushwalking? A spell is cast on my friend. They cannot connect with their common sense! My friend walks off a low cliff! They did not hurt themselves, but they are slowly bleeding to death. I try to quickly go with them, but they are unable to move from where I'm standing. That's just real life, mate. Like this! This is already something that happens. Let's be real here. I am behind a large freight sheet. my naked emotions almost visible to everyone. I'm stressed at my breaking point. Suddenly, someone pulls the sheet to the ground. Everyone I have ever known can see every part of me in which I tried so hard to hide. I think I'm at the age whereby I don't even try to hide much anymore. Other than, like, you know, obviously real life identities and stuff. In terms of how I feel, I'm not gonna hide that. Like, it's just emotions are just what makes us people. There's no use hiding it. It's like, if people don't like you for having emotions, then maybe they're the messed up ones. I horrifically wake up to a blinding light shining straight at me. When my eyes adjust, I look to the top of the light to find every person I know looking down at me. They look confused. They've known me for years, but their expressions show they don't even recognize me. Why are you looking at me then? Hello, why are you looking at me? My arms are tied to an imaginary chain above me. A scary shadow is controlling them above me. Like I'm a puppet. The shadow forces me to do embarrassing to torturous things. All in front of a large crowd, full of mockery. Oh boy. Yeah, that's a bit, I'm walking down the street, minding my own business, till a stranger comes up to me and starts to stab my stomach with a butcher's knife. I can't feel anything, but it makes me confused. I look around and see a police officer looking straight at me. It is clear they saw what happened, however, did nothing. I suddenly realize that everywhere I look is the same, a lawless, chaotic, and dangerous world. It is here to stay. So it's basically the Purge. All of these are bonkers. Well, except for maybe this, like this. This is a little bit more believable, but in terms of what I don't want, it's like, yeesh. It's like, let me lose my friends, but don't stab me.
See you in your dreams.
Okay, you're associating with a personality type that makes you want to run and hide. What personality type is this exactly? Something that makes me want to run? Probably someone who is overly aggressive. Like, I've had my fair share of these kind of people take them away from me. You are standing in the forest. There's a terrifying creature there. What is it?
A human!
Something that is out to hurt specifically everyone I ever cared about. Creature. These two is kind of like dependent, I guess. Creature with many heads, constantly out to get me. A monster which can read all my deepest and darkest thoughts. If they're just reading my thoughts, it's like, bro, you're a creep, but it's not really actively harming me. Creature that is making me apologize. Apology to every one of my enemies. Oh god. Oh god, that's rough. But I don't think I have a lot of enemies, but I mean, if I apologize to them, it's like, hopefully they can make this over. Probably this. This seems bad. This seems like it's actually trying to kill me.
Now you're in a calm lake. All of a sudden, the water in it starts to tremble uncontrollably. How do you feel about this?
Just worried. I'm probably like, should I worry about this? Picture yourself in a small room with nothing in it. But both the walls and the floor are painted one color that makes your eyes bleed. Oh, this color B? Yellow. Like the back rooms. Oh god, multicolored. That'll just be a headache, but it'll depend on what it's like.
or like how it's actually painted. It says one color. That's not one color. That's contradicts with the question. I'm gonna go with red. Like, red is fine, but I think that's... I mean, my eyes are bleeding. It's probably gonna be red at the end of it. I really hope this experiment works for you. For the time being, thanks for being my personal guinea pig. Thanks? Nurturer protector. I'm a female, so I am a caring, bubbly, and selfless person. No matter who anyone may be, you feel the need to look after them. I know this because you fear losing the ability to take care of others, being stuck in one place when someone is in trouble. Whatever you say, bro.